Up to 250,000 Aucklanders a week are set to face massive disruptions to train travel due to a $330 million rail upgrade. But Auckland Transport says alternatives will be in place and it's short-term pain for long-term gain. Business correspondent Katie Bradford reports.
The foundations of Auckland's rail lines, some nearly as old as the city itself. But now, line by line, kilometre by kilometre, the tracks and ground are to be ripped out and replaced.
It's the first time since the 1890s that this type of work has been done.
It's difficult and invasive work.
So it's a bit like, you know, doing up a house or something like that. At some point you've got to redo the foundations, and it's best to do it now before City Rail Link opens.
That's the good news. The bad news, it'll cause mass disruption to passengers.
It is going to be difficult for some.
After the usual closures over Christmas and New Year's, between January and March, there'll be no services departing Newmarket to Onehunga and Otahuhu. Then from March through December, no Eastern Line services. Commuter services between Pukekohe and Papakura remain closed until late 2024. And it doesn't end there. All other lines will be affected heading into 2024 and 2025.
It'll be a bit of a loss, really, but they've got to do the upgrades and it's all going to be in the bigger picture.
It's really hard to catch the train already because they always delay all the time.
Auckland Transport is promising there will be bus replacement services across most affected rail lines, but the agency has copped criticism recently for poor communication and many cancelled services. In fact, 10% of all bus services recently have been cancelled.
Are you confident there'll be enough buses?
Definitely a challenge, but it is an opportunity to get to a network, a rail network that will actually allow us finally to deliver reliable, safe and many train services in the future.
Other solutions, temporary bus lanes to speed up travel times, and the hunt is on for more drivers and operators.
And if that is not sufficient, we'll be looking at alternative options to look beyond the typical public transport operators.
They promise it'll be worth it in the long run.
People in New Zealand understand that if you don't invest in your infrastructure, at some point it breaks down, and the breakdown is worse.
Ensuring trains stay on track, but keeping Aucklanders on side, a much bigger challenge. Katie Bradford, One News.